Hi folks. In this video, I will talk about risk assessments. These are the centerpieces of automotive cybersecurity. Perhaps you know the so-called TARA, threat analysis and risk assessment, the comprehensive risk assessment for the concept phase. Therefore, Clause 8 of the coming ISO SAE 24034 industry standard outlines the basic elements of a risk assessment. With the Nine2Five TARA Navigator, I present a practice-proofed approach how you can perform your first risk assessment in a smart and structured manner. My name is Thomas Liedtke. I am a cybersecurity expert at Kugler Mark & Company. I train practitioners on cybersecurity in the automotive sector and advise companies on this topic since over a decade. Well, the connected car and its components must be safe and secure during its entire lifetime. For this, you must protect your products against cyber attacks. Otherwise, you accept that your stakeholders will suffer losses in terms of safety, finance, operations, or privacy terms. That is not a good option. But do you really know all the potential threat scenarios that your vehicle project will be exposed to? You can neither foresee the motivation nor the abilities of an attacker in future. To cope with this challenge, you must continuously find out if, where and how your product is vulnerable, what harm is associated with the threat, and how you intend to manage the impact of the threats. A risk analysis is a procedure in which findings are checked and related to each other in a structured and step-by-step manner. The 9to5 TARA Navigator includes 9 steps and 5 targets. In this video, I will now explain this procedure to you. Think of your TARA procedure like a string of pearls. Like another pearl, we always add another analysis or identification step to the previous, from the very left to the right of a string. With each step, you only must think about one topic. Before you can start with your TARA, you must define your item first. This is a subsystem or a set of subsystems, for example, a function on vehicle level or a control unit. Describe the environment of the system, its functions, interactions, and what interfaces there are. Are you complete with this preliminary work? Number 1. Then we come to our first analytical step, the so-called asset identification. An asset belongs to your item, and it is worth protecting. It defines a property crucial for a stakeholder. Take, for example, the internet communication channel. Hardly any electronic system is conceivable without this asset. Encryption keys or safety goals are further examples. However, the asset is very interesting for both parties, for your stakeholder, who thus gets the required functionality, as well as for an attacker to compromise your system. Therefore, the primary step is to enumerate all your assets. What can go wrong? Systematically question each of the assets in terms of confidentiality, integrity and availability, as well as non-repudiation, authenticity and authorization. The ISO SAE 24034 standard describes these attributes as cybersecurity properties. You identify the damage scenarios by evaluation what can happen if cybersecurity properties or assets are compromised. This was the asset identification in short. Step number 2 on our string of pearls is called impact rating. Here we evaluate the damage scenarios according to what consequences they may have for your stakeholders. This includes functional safety, finance, operations, and privacy. Tables help to determine the severity of a damage. The catch here is that not every stakeholder is equally affected by every damage scenario. By the way, we have also achieved our first target. We have rated the impact of damage. Number 3. The next step is about the identification of our threat scenario. In the first step, we have spoken about the potential damage, for example, caused by a compromised cybersecurity property. Now, we look at the selected assets again and ask what threat scenario may arise. To make this clear, we take a compromised switch as an example. This damage scenario results in a possible threat scenario, namely caused by spoofing or flooding the canvas. The attack path analysis is our point number 4. The defect switch from our example is somewhere in the middle of the vehicle. In order to compromise the canvas, an attacker has to find a way through the system. The ISO standard now thinks backwards. What path must be potential attacker follow for the threat scenario to occur? This hike is called attack path. You'll find a list of samples of vulnerabilities provided by the UNICE regulations. So, see if these vulnerabilities are relevant in your system. If yes, then check if they can support you to identify further threat scenarios. Theory is fine, but is the attack realistic? Number 5. This question points us to the next step. The attack feasibility rating. In practice, not every attack can be conducted. Maybe encryption makes it unlikely. Therefore, we now look at the actual attack potential. There are 5 key parameters for your evaluation. Elapsed time, the required expertise and product know-how, as well as equipment and the window of opportunity. Once we know whether an attacker can conduct an attack successfully, we have achieved target number 2, rating of the feasibility of an attack. Number 6. Now it is time for determination of the risk value. For this step, we combine the results of both targets, impact rating, first target, and attack feasibility rating, second target. We therefore have 2 ratings that determine the risk value. The impact of the associated damage scenario and the attack feasibility of the attack path. However, we usually have different stakeholders. Some of them assess the risk very differently. That makes things tricky. We may have to apply a different risk value for each stakeholder. In any case, we have achieved the third target. We know the risk value. Step number 7 is called risk treatment decision. Once risks are on the table, the question is how to deal with them. There are basically a set of options for dealing with that risk. First option, avoidance. Second, reduction, for example, by specifying a security control, technical or organizational, or introducing redundancy. Third option, sharing or transfer to third parties, and finally, fourth, acceptance. Now decide how you want to manage the risk. Please keep in mind it is very tricky to judge how effective a cybersecurity control is. However, this is where every risk assessment stands and falls. Our 8th step brings us to the cybersecurity goals. The cybersecurity goals and claims are derived from A, the results of the TARA, and B, your decisions on how the risk should ultimately be dealt with. If you decide that you want to avoid a risk, then you go back to square one. You may consider an alternative technical solution. The cybersecurity goals form a 4th target of a TARA. Now we are on the home stretch. Step 9. The last point is on the cybersecurity concept. The cybersecurity concept is derived from the cybersecurity goals. It describes how do you want to put the cybersecurity goals in practice. Derive requirements from the goals and allocate them to your architecture, that means to the relevant components of your systems or organization. These requirements and their allocation to the architecture are all described in the cybersecurity concept. The cybersecurity concept captures all cybersecurity requirements and their allocation. This is our last target. Well, that takes us through all the 9 steps I recommend performing. You have seen that all steps build on each other. Like a string of pearls, the next step usually refers to its predecessor and evaluates it or develops it further. Let me conclude by summarizing the 9to5 TARA Navigator. Define your item or your system to prepare the TARA. First step. Identify your assets. This includes the enumeration of your assets, the alignment with the cybersecurity properties, and the identification of a damage scenario. Secondly, rate the impact on the potential damage. This leads you to the first target, the impact rating. Number 3. Identify your threat scenarios. Fourth step, analyze attack paths. Fifth step, analyze the attack feasibility. The second target indicates the ease of an attack. Number 6. Determine the risk. Target number 3 names the risk level. Step number 7. Decide how to treat the risk. 8. Derive the cybersecurity goals. These goals are our target number 4. They lead directly to our fifth target, the cybersecurity concept. Step number 9. Allocate the cybersecurity requirements to your components. So now you know how you can perform a threat analysis and risk assessment according to the ISO SAE 24034. Please keep in mind that the international standard expects you to perform a risk assessment not only once, but on a regular basis. If you would like to read all of this at your leisure or perhaps integrate it into your company training program, then use the link in the description to download the corresponding white paper. If you liked the video and are interested in further specialty topics, please subscribe to this Kugler Mark & Company YouTube channel and watch more videos. And maybe you will recommend our videos to your colleagues. See you soon!